Hi, I'm Tom Hoover from Emerson. I'm here to talk today about Branson laser plastic welding. We have two primary branches of a tree for laser plastic welding available to the market today. One branch will take us to product designers. It's a very effective way to develop their product. And another branch is for high-speed automation. So let me talk at a successful product that's going to be used in high-speed automation. Essentially, what we do is take laser diode energy and put it discreetly around the part perimeter. I'm going to give you an example. This is a laser cutaway tool. If we could look inside this tool, you would see laser bundles bringing down individual pattern that would match the part's design. What this allows a customer to do is take contoured parts, parts with shapes to it, and it'll allow you to bring, if this was my imaginary part, allow you to bring energy down and apply it to the side, around the perimeter, around the top, or all at once. That requires a very distinctly designed tool for that operation. This is a very fast, very clean, and efficient joining technology for plastics. Typical cycle time, less than 3 seconds on most parts. These tools are widely used in industry now for high-speed automation. Now, the one attribute of this is a tool that is designed specifically for the part. So if you're going to make a part change, you're going to need to make a tool change. So we have a solution for that as well. So if we come over here, what we have is a single point Galvo. So this is a laser source using the same kind of diode laser energy, 890 nanometers. And what this does is rather than the tool come down over the part, this shines a light down onto the surface of the part. Predominantly used in microfluidics or in product development. This is a good starting place for developing a product that perhaps has many fluid pathways through it, and perhaps it is critically important to not contribute any contaminant to the weld. Almost any other plastic joining technology offered uses some kind of vibratory energy which creates particulate. Here we are using photons to weld. Photons are absorbed in one half of the part and conduct to the top half of the part, creating a hermetic seal if needed. It's very fast, it's very efficient. Galvo welding is perhaps a second or two slower, but there's no major tool changes should you need to make a change in your part. It is a simple matter of changing a program in the tool, and it changes the trace pattern around the part. So here we're going to demonstrate a trace pattern across a simulated microfluidic part. I'll place the part into the welder, and the first thing you will see is a clamp force come up and be applied to the part. Okay, and this cycle initiates. And up here, we can see the light tracing around the pattern. So although this part is small, there could be 40 to 50 linear inches of weld contained within that. So what you saw tracing around a pattern is moving very quickly, maybe going over a spot that we know we have to apply more energy, or moving quickly over a part where we don't need to add energy. That's our completed part.